The U.S. election countdown is on. American voters holding the future direction of the planet in their grasp. So who will end up on top? You want to be right here tomorrow. U.S. election coverage starts early at the Sun News Network. We'll be updating you on the latest developments starting at 6 o'clock in the morning. You don't want to miss a thing. And the in-depth insight begins at 5 p.m. Primetime coverage begins with our very own Sun News All-Stars, including yours truly. And, of course, Byline's Brian Lilley. Brian, what's your call? A lot of newspapers that pointed this out earlier in our Canadian Common Sense that have been supporting Democrats over the years, like the New York Daily News, now supporting Romney. Is there something in the drinking water?
There could be, but at this point, Charles, I'm saying it's too close to call. And I'm not just saying that because I want people to tune in tomorrow and not say, oh, it's a foregone conclusion, Romney's going to win or Obama's going to win. I actually think it's too close to call. We could end up seeing not exactly a blowout, but close to a sweep by Romney if certain states break his way. But these states, including Pennsylvania, Michigan, Wisconsin, so close to call. Ohio, President Obama surging ahead a little bit there. That makes it more difficult for Romney to win if he doesn't have Ohio, but then he's pulled even in places like Pennsylvania, where he has no right to be pulling even if you listen to the commentariat. So it is going to be a nail biter. If these things split for Romney, he's going to win big. If they don't, we could be sitting there all night to find out who gets 270, 271, 279 Electoral College votes. And at the end of the day, you know, if you haven't figured out the Electoral College system, just think of it like seats in our Canadian system. They've got to win not just the popular vote, but enough seats to be able to take the presidency.
Brian, we could talk about the punditocracy and, you know, where it's been up and down. We could talk about the polls, many of which are, you know, even though they're calling for Obama, they're only calling for Obama in some states by 2 or 3 points, which means within the margin of error, therefore, there won't be egg on their faces. They've played it safe. If Romney does a sweep, they'll be able to say, well, we were within the margin of error. But I want to move away from that just to talk about fundamentals and to Canadianize the conversation, if you don't mind. If we had unemployment in this country twice as high as what it is right now, if we had debt levels three times as high as what it is right now, if we had a stagnant housing market, would anybody who is currently sitting in the prime minister's office be thought of as electable?
In this country, most likely not. You know, I still think that our unemployment rate is far too high in Canada at 7.4%, although I remember back in Chrétien's days in the 90s, him saying unemployment, we were full unemployment when we were close to 10%, and youth unemployment was really high, the way it is in the United States right now. And I remember being a young guy, going contract to contract, struggling to find permanent work, and it was really difficult. And I remember hearing him say, well, we're at full unemployment. And I thought, to heck with you. What the heck are you talking about? You're sitting fine. There might be some of that going on in the United States right now. Their unemployment rate looks like it's just a bit above ours. It's at 7.9%. But a lot of people aren't looking for jobs anymore. They don't have them, and they're not looking. That pushes down the participation rate, Charles. And I'll give you a quick stat here. If the participation rate was at the same level it was when George Bush left office, the U.S. unemployment rate would be at about 10.5%. That's how many Americans have just said, you know what, I've been looking for 3 months, 6 months, 2 years, and I can't find work. I'm just not looking anymore. I don't know how they're getting by. Well, obviously food stamps, which are up dramatically, up to 47 million from closer to 30 million. So, you know, with these types of numbers, no one would be considered electable. But there's a big chunk of America that that I think still says, well, Obama inherited all of this mess. And so they're giving him a second chance. I saw a picture posted online on the weekend. It said, is George Bush standing there? And they said, well, if Obama gets a second term, just think of the mess he'll inherit then, because he's going to inherit his own mess. And things are not good in the U.S. That's why in Canada, we have to want the Americans to elect Romney to turn around their economy, because that will help drive down our unemployment rate.
Well, going back to the states, it just seems to me that for Obama to win this, for the numbers to be accurate, Obama's got to pull the strings as effectively on his so-called base as he did 4 years ago, primarily youth, Latinos, and blacks. And it just seems, as far as those three important demographics are concerned, there is not nearly the level of enthusiasm among those folks that there was 4 years ago. So I don't know how he pulls that rabbit out of his hat, Brian.
Well, and if Obama does lose, it will be because, I think, of what is called the enthusiasm gap. Young people aren't excited. Nobody is as excited as they were in 2008. And so when you see that those numbers are tied, what the Romney camp has to be hoping for is that they are, they're tied, but that the people that are actually going to show up and vote are the people that are going to vote for Romney. That's what they have to be hoping for. And the Obama campaign knows that they've got an enthusiasm problem. And that's why, instead of reaching into the center, he keeps going for things that will gin up the base. Because you've always got to play two fronts in politics. You've got to say the things that get your base excited, and then you've got to say those things that get the people in the middle that switch back and forth excited. And lately, he's been going after the base more than he's been going after the middle. You know, another line on the weekend where he went off teleprompter, that could end up hurting him, where he said, don't boo. He mentioned Mitt Romney and the crowd booed. He said, don't boo, vote. Voting is the best revenge. That's a far cry from Mitt Romney saying, vote in the best interests of the country. Obama sounded like he was an angry, just an angry man, a bitter man. And that's not the way the president should be sounding if he's going to be the guy that pulls everyone together, which is what Obama's been claiming for the last 5-6 years as he's been campaigning, and I'd like to say governing, but mostly he's been campaigning the last 4 years.
Yeah, he's been coming across in the last little while as the angry shareholder throwing tomatoes at the CEO, and Romney's been looking on TV very much like the CEO. Brian, we love your look, we love your sound, and we'll love being with you tomorrow night.
All right, talk to you then.